So I was looking through the Q&A questions for the very hilariously delayed Q&A for May, and one of the questions asked me what I thought about a Splatoon 3 Battle Royale mode. And I was like, why would we have that? Why would we have that? And then my brain was like, oh, but why would we have that? And I was like, oh, we're making a video now, aren't we, Brain? And Brain was like, yes, we're making a video now. So this is unscripted. I just really wanted to talk about this because the more that I think about it, I was like, actually, this could probably work if Nintendo does it right. Now, as we know, Battle Royale games tend to either be, you know, team on team on team on team on team, etc., or one on many. So you have to wonder, how can the game make this work without making it such a big mess? We can't really have a Splatoon game where we just have 100 colors, let's say, all over the field. That wouldn't be very easy to see. It'd be a mess for anybody that's colorblind, because we all know that the color lock options in Splatoon 2 leave a little bit to be desired. In my opinion, as soon as we introduce a third color to the mix, things start to get a little bit confusing very fast. I mean, you get like 10? It's not gonna work out too well. So I feel like the only way they'd be able to pull this off is if it was just, like, one color for you and one color for everybody else. The only real downside to this is that you wouldn't be able to see where other people are swimming. So if you're trying to fight somebody, you wouldn't be able to tell what color ink actually belongs to your opponent and what doesn't. But this would at least allow you to have your ink color and know where you can go. I don't know, man. Where there's a will, there's a way. What if, when you locked onto a specific opponent, that would be the only time that you ever saw a third color? That could be a good way to get around it. If you limit the game to at maximum three colors on the screen, like, let's say, your color, a enemy color on the opposite side of the color spectrum, and a neutral color like they have in some of the games, you'd be able to do a pretty good battle royale no matter how many people are in the room. It could be three, it could be four, it could be 100 people, whatever the game feels like is right. Although in the end, I think the most important thing would have to be map size. Maybe they'd have bigger maps where you could have more players, and smaller maps where they'd have, you know, less players. I think a good number of players would be like 20. I don't see a need for more than maybe like 20 on the screen. It might depend on how long these matches are supposed to last anyway. I mean, Splatoon is usually known for having relatively short matches, so I can't imagine them having more than like 5 or 10 minutes on the clock for one of these games. The whole point of Splatoon is you're supposed to be able to pick it up, play a game or two if you want, and then be able to put it back down and do something else. Or just play a whole bunch of the same mode over and over and over again for a rotation and actually feel like you've accomplished something. If every game took like 30 minutes like it might in a real battle royale game, then it just wouldn't have that same rewarding feeling that you're used to having. Assuming one player gets clapped every, let's say, 20, 30 seconds, probably less in some cases, but let's say like 20 seconds, then you would need to clap 3 people per minute at that rate, right? So if you had 10 minutes, that could be like 30 people. Not bad. Ooh, and it could take even longer if you don't like start with a weapon. Maybe you just start with nothing, Octo Expansion style, and you gotta actually find a weapon of your own, kind of like they do in Fortnite. Like, surprise! You get to play the game with a Splattershot Jr. But you see that person over there? They actually got to start with an E-Leader! Better start running, lol. Assuming that we're sticking to the you can only see up to two colors on the screen thing we talked about before, I think it'd be safe to say that in this mode, you probably wouldn't have Ninja Squid. I think that'd be the only way to make it work. That way you can at least see where everybody is swimming around you, since everything's gonna probably look the same color except for your own ink. In a way, it kinda would become a super glorified version of hide and seek, because you would just be running around, probably jumping at random piles of enemy ink, and kinda hoping that somebody would be in there. That actually kinda sounds like a lot of fun. It's danger hide and seek. Especially if the maps are small enough, you wouldn't really need to worry about forcing people to kind of squish into an area. I can imagine there would probably be an easy way to force people out. Let's say, maybe if only 2 minutes are left on the map, instead of having some natural force kind of cause people to have to move in towards a part of the map, why not have some third party come into the game? Something that would make you have to do stuff, or else maybe you'd be in danger too. Cue bad guys. But not just any bad guys. I'm talking either number one, bad guys from Splatoon 1 or Splatoon 2's, like, hero mode, or Maybe bad guys from the third hero mode that we just don't know about yet. Maybe you can only access this mode after you've completed the story mode, giving the story mode actual value for once? Since there's no real reason to complete the story mode in Splatoon 1 or Splatoon 2 besides the fact of, hey, I want to do a story mode, or hey, I kind of need a tutorial on how to play the video game. If neither of those two things are things that you really care about, you might just not even bother to do the hero mode, unless you want, like, the hero weapons. Imagine this. Time is running low. There's like a minute and a half left on the clock. You are left, and like five other people are left, and you're on some new version of Salt Spray Rig, let's go with. How the heck is the video game gonna make you get closer to people? Why not just add in Octobombers? You know, the one that flies in the sky and ends up kinda near you and then drops bombs down on you? I think that'd be a great way to make you move. If someone's nearby and happens to see you move, or you're nearby and see somebody else move, boom. Instant combat. Someone's probably gonna get bopped. And at the same time, you gotta, like, not die to the bombs, because those are still kind of happening. Kind of like how in Smash, when you end up, like, playing for too long and you end up in sudden death, and then it's like, oh, you're not actually dying fast enough, lol, here's bob-bombs on the field. But now instead of bob-bombs, you got splat-bombs. And everyone knows that a good old splat-bomb is not a thing you really want to toy with for too long if you can. And of course, you'd still have access to, like, the map, so you could see probably exactly where people are hiding if you start seeing bomb explosions going off on the other side of the map. This, I feel like, would prevent you from having too many times where there would just be too many people alive by the end of a match. But if they don't want to include extra AI, there's other things that could track down you without actually having to be opponents. Why not just have a small trickle of torpedoes that show up? Like, they start in the air, and they kind of fall down until they see somebody, and then they just float all the way down to your opponents. Or to you, if they're the first one that they see. That way, there'd always be a way for you to start tracking down other people, besides just having to look at the map. Or, a third really mean option would be for the game to vaguely tell you which direction the closest person is to you. Like, maybe once every couple of seconds, you get a little arrow that pops up that just kind of points in a direction, like left, or right, or forward, or backward. Nothing more than that. Kind of like what you see from, like, a this way, or a booyah. Slowly put you in the right direction.
The direction to a fight.
Ooh, and then, if, let's say, all the time goes down and there are still people in the middle of the map, here's how you get rid of everybody in like 10 seconds, like easy. Game hits that 10 minute mark. You hear the overtime like sirens blare, like the womp, womp, womp. And then instantly, you just get super jumped to the middle of the map. You and whoever the heck is all left, oops, now y'all gotta fight. You better be ready. Now you gotta fight. It just sounds like a nightmare. It just sounds like such a terrible idea that I would love to just see them do that. Just be like, oops, were you trying to avoid people this whole time because your mechanics aren't very good? Well, you better be good at fighting now, because now you gotta fight all the other three people left at the same time. We could have it like, you can't leave a very specific area. Like, finally we do that. Like, splash walls on the top, and splash walls on the bottom, and splash walls on the sides, so you can only move within a certain area until nobody's left except just one person. And hopefully that one person is you. I think it's the perfect little nightmare. I'm very glad I saw that Q&A question, because I kind of like thinking about this. Splatoon 3 is good, and it's fun just to think about things that they might put into the video game, even if it's probably not too likely. If you have ideas of things that you want me to talk about, or you want to expand on this idea in the comments, please have at it. And subscribe if you like this kind of thing. I'll probably keep doing videos like these every once in a while. Thank you for listening. This has been Vic, and I hope you have a good one.